You can sense that there's a bit of disapproval here and there lah. Like my mother will drop hints like, hey, you know that there's this job at leh, not bad leh.
My name is Yong Ting. I'm 28.
I'm John Lam, 28 this year also. So we are both hawkers at Q Hor Fun.
I think the inspiration behind the name Q Hor Fun came pretty conveniently because my good friends call me Ting. Then after that, we conveniently came up with Q Hor Fun. It was very candid actually. The formation of the logo kind of fits very nicely, and Hor Fun can be like QQ and stuff like that. So that's how we came up with the name.
Our first dish, the Yuan Yang, is actually the amalgamation of both the curry and mushroom herbal sauce with fried chicken.
A lot of people come here wanting to have the chicken, wanting to have the pork, and then sometimes they stand over there and, what should I have today? So instead of having to make people choose, why not give them a, you know, yeah, the best of all three worlds, I guess.
So for our pork chop with mushroom as well as our curry pork chop, it's just the same dish but different sauces. Curry with Hor Fun is not a very common thing. People tend to associate Ipoh Hor Fun with the herbal sauce. So the infusion of curry is really interesting because curry is savory by itself and Hor Fun itself is sweet because it's a rice noodles.
What we're trying to do is just to, I guess, provide people with more options. And instead of doing it the traditional way and conventional way, we're trying to do it in a more refreshing manner.
Prior to this, I was in the events industry.
I am doing accounting. I'm currently still studying to complete my ACCA. That's professional qualification under accountancy. We have no prior experience in commercial cooking. I think the best dish I probably could have cooked back then, back in the days before I started here, was Maggie Mee. I think that's pretty much the same for the both of us.
When I just started, right, I actually screwed up quite badly also a few times. It was then when I actually was like, okay, you know, I actually had to take it very seriously and to actually go and hone my craft.
Ever since we started out here, then we just learned everything from scratch. So I think getting burnt marks and getting cut here and there is something quite common. I think all of us got a fair share of it. The biggest hardship would be getting up very, very, very early in the morning and then coming here to stand the whole day and then basically sweat your whole body out. It's a pretty huge culture shock and it's pretty taxing on the body, especially when you're not used to it in the beginning. Definitely being in a corporate world, there's a lot more stability. And then if you're buying a house and stuff like that, things get a lot easier. When you're self-employed, everything is uncertain. So I guess they're just very uncomfortable with the uncertainty.
For me, pretty much the same. You can sense that there's a bit of disapproval here and there lah. Like my mother will drop hints like, hey, you know that there's this job at leh, not bad leh. They are just hinting to me very subtly lah. I think they learn how to respect my decision.
Yuan Yang is something I think that made me really proud. It is something really new and probably not sold anywhere else. Initially, we have lots of customers coming back to ask, what is Yuan Yang? Nowadays, we have customers coming back to tell me they want Yuan Yang Hor Fun. From something not known until today, people coming here to ask for it. It's a sense of achievement.
I think that the real motivation really kicked in when customers come back to us and actually feedback. Curry is really good, you know. To me, it's like, wow, at least I made someone happy. Someone enjoyed what I cooked that day. Then it made me more motivated to do better.
Just do it. Especially when you are young, this is the best time to try whatever you want to try. Give it your best shot and see if it works for you.
Just give it a shot. Fail, then you know, learn from it, take it as an experience.
This is the right way to YOLO.